this video of graph theory part 3, I will explain about complete graph, connected graph, disconnected graph and components. So let us start. Here we have three graphs in which we can see that there is an edge between every pair of vertices. So what is a complete graph? Complete graph is a simple graph in which there exists an edge between every pair of vertices. So here we have two vertices and both are connected. Here three vertices and there exists an edge between every pair of vertices. Here four vertices are there and the same. So this is the example of complete graph. Now we have a theorem where we have to show that a complete graph with n vertices consists n into n minus 1 by 2 edges. So let us take G to be a complete graph having n vertices. So we have a graph G with n vertices. Let V be a vertex of G. We'll take a vertex small v of G. Now the remaining vertices are n minus 1. So each of the remaining n minus 1 vertices is adjacent to V. G has no loop and parallel edges. Hence, degree of each vertex is n minus 1. So here, the graph is complete. Complete graph is a simple graph. And simple graph is a graph having no loop and parallel edges. So G has no loop and parallel edges. So degree of each vertex is n minus 1. Thus, the sum of degrees of the vertices is the number of vertices n into the degree of each vertex, that is n minus 1. So sum of degrees of the vertices is n into n minus 1, which is twice the total number of edges. Hence, if this is equal to twice of E, what will be the number of edges? It will be n into n minus 1 by 2. Hence, in a complete graph, the number of edges is n into n minus 1 by 2. Let us verify it in a complete graph. So here we have a complete graph with 5 vertices, v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. And we have to find out number of edges. So now we have a formula, n into n minus 1 by 2 to find out the number of edges. So here we have n is equal to 5. Number of edges E will be 5 into 5 minus 1, that is 4 by 2. So after cancelling, we'll get number of edges to be 10. So with the help of this formula, we can find out the number of edges in a complete graph. Next is connected and disconnected graph. A graph G is said to be connected if there is at least one path between every pair of vertices in G. If this happens, then it is a connected graph. Otherwise, it is said to be disconnected. So here we have three examples. In part A, you can see three vertices are there and each one is connected. Each one is connected with at least one path. Here we have two vertices. It is connected with one path. Here we have six vertices and each is connected with one path. This one with all three. This again with all three. Then here with all three. And this one is also with all three. So, graph is connected. These are the examples of connected graph. Here we have examples of disconnected graph. So here the graph is disconnected because there is no path between these two vertices. Here also the same thing. So these are the examples of disconnected graph. Now there is one more term, component. A disconnected graph consists of two or more connected graph. If a graph is disconnected, then it is containing two or more connected graphs. So each these connected subgraphs of the disconnected graph is called a component. And a component is itself a graph. So we'll have a theorem. We'll prove that a simple graph with n vertices and m components can have at most n minus m into n minus m plus 1 by 2 edges. So we have a simple graph with n vertices and number of components are m. Then the number of edges will be n minus m into n minus m plus 1 by 2. Let us start the proof. We'll take G to be a simple graph and with m components. And let that components be C1, C2 and Cm. Let Ni be the number of vertices in the component Ci. I is from 1 to m. Then summation of Ni, where I is from 1 to m, is equal to small n. Let us take it as equation number 1. Since G is taken to be a simple graph, so the maximum possible number of edges will be half into Ni into Ni minus 1. Hence, the number of edges in the graph G will be less than equal to summation I is equal to 1 to m half Ni into Ni minus 1. This will multiply and write it separately. So it will be equal to half into Ni will become Ni square. And half into minus half into summation I is equal to 1 to m Ni. This we can write. From equation 1 we know that summation I is equal to 1 to m Ni is equal to n. So this will reduce to half. Summation I is equal to 1 to m Ni square minus half of n. Now, for any m positive integer, n1, n2, nm, we have n1 minus 1 plus n2 minus 1 plus nm minus 1 is equal to, here n1 plus n2 plus nm will take, and minus 1 is how many times? M times. So minus of m. So in place of this, n1 plus n2 plus nm, we can write n. So this will be equal to n minus m. Now, on squaring here, n1 minus 1 whole square plus n2 minus 1 whole square plus nm minus 1 whole square excuse me, plus 2n1 minus 1 into n2 minus 1 plus 2n1 minus 1 into n3 minus 1 plus dot dot dot. This way it will go on. And on the right hand side, it will be n minus m whole square. Hence, n1 minus 1 whole square plus n2 minus 1 whole square plus nm minus 1 whole square is less than equal to n minus m whole square. Now, this can be written as n1 square plus n2 square plus dot 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 nm square. minus 2 of n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus dot 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 till nm and plus m is less than equal to n minus m whole square. So in place of this we can write 2 into n plus m less than equal to n minus m whole square. Hence the number of edges is less than equal to half ni square minus half n is less than equal to half of n minus m whole square plus twice of n. If this we will take on the right hand side, it will be twice of n and this will become minus n. So it is written like this, and minus half of n. So on expanding this, it will be equal to half into n square minus 2m plus m square plus 2n minus m minus n. Half is taken common. So this is what? This is n minus m whole square, and here 2n minus n will become n and n minus m. Among these two, if we'll take n minus m common, what is left here? Here n minus m and here plus 1. So the number of edges in graph G will be equal to half into n minus m into n minus m plus 1, which we have to prove. So we have discussed about complete graph, connected graph and components and a theorem that a simple graph with n vertices and m components can have at most n minus m into n minus m plus 1 by 2 edges. Thank you.